Now, I took our little Land Rover for a cheeky test drive after Mike left. And actually, mechanically, it's really rather sound. Unfortunately, it's definitely no rocket ship. But actually, I've got far more serious things to worry about, because for a change, Mike's actually admitted to the state of the underside of this vehicle, and it's not good. Now, the Series 2A Land Rover is considered one of the hardiest of all of the incarnations, which is actually a good thing considering what we'd like to do with it, but also how hard a life it looks like this one has led. Sorry, Henry has led. Now, if you talk to any Land Rover enthusiast, and let's face it, there are quite a few, they will tell you it doesn't matter what condition your Land Rover is in, it's never a lost cause. Well, they are kind of right to a point. Well, there is definitely a lot of rust, a lot of peeling paint, but I can't see too many really bad holes. It's not looking terminal, which is a good thing. And I'm sure there is some actual metal under here somewhere. But let's face it, Mike has never understated a problem before, has he? Now, they say that desperate times call for desperate measures. And this chassis needs a ton of work doing to it. I think the only real way of doing it properly is to separate it from the body. First, I loosen and remove all the bolts from the frame of our Henry. 30 in all, very tedious. Well, I think that is pretty much everything on the underside. I now need to go topside and remove everything else. Up top, I have to drain and remove the radiator and oil cooler. I'm removing any electrical wires, especially those that lead into the cab. Now, I'm pretty sure this is everything I need to disconnect in the cab, so I think we're getting there. And now for the slam panel and wings. Last few bits of reinforcement, and then we are ready to lift the body off the chassis, assuming I've undone everything. Right, well, with the body now away from the chassis, you can really see what's going on. And unfortunately, the chassis is definitely filthy, but I'm sure with a really good wash, we'll be able to see then exactly what we're playing with, whether it's good or bad. One quick pressure wash later, there are two clear reasons for taking this rather dramatic course of action. It makes it easier to work on every aspect of the car and delivers 100% peace of mind. You know there are no hidden gremlins. Thankfully, giving the chassis a good clean has made all of the difference because, as Mike suggested, it doesn't actually look that bad at all, but it obviously needs a ton of work to get it looking really rather lovely. But the good thing about having the body off, of course, is we can now have really good access to all the things that Mike was talking about that needed work, the suspension, the steering, the brakes. But before I can do anything, I do need to put in a lot of elbow grease. Starting with air chiseling off the undercoating. And now to use the wire brush to remove the remainder of the undercoating and loose rust. We're getting some great news here. Basically, every layer of paint and dirt and rust that I cut through to, I always end up with nice, good, solid metal, which is fantastic. Only thing is, to do this chassis any justice, I do need to take all the bits off and just carry on tons and tons of elbow grease. Now, we all know that for a house to last at least a lifetime, it needs to have a fantastic foundation. That's exactly the same thing with a car.
The Series 2 vehicle chassis is referred to as a sturdy box section ladder because it's made up of four strips of steel welded to each side to form a box. This shape all but eliminated complex welding otherwise used on U or I section frames.
Now, our Land Rover's chassis, its foundation, probably had more surface rust than it did nice clean patches, so something had to be done. So it's been blasted, all the parts have been taken off, everything's been powder coated, and now finally it's ready to go back together and hopefully should last for decades to come.
The media blasting cost a mere $150 and the powder coating $629. Under $800 or £500 for years and years of clean, protected chassis. Another advantage to starting with a fresh chassis when bolting all of our new components is ease of fitment. An easy install along with new hardware avoids a lot of frustration. With the chassis in this state, I can also use the lift to help install the axles, saving time and a lot of back pain. First, I attach one end of the leaf spring to the chassis. With the axles perched securely on axle stands, I can easily mount the wheels to the axle. Then simply roll the entire axle over as a unit. New bolts and bottom plates secure the axle to the leaf springs. And then simply lower the chassis to mate with the other half of the leaf spring. A little motivation with the mallet and the leaf spring slips into the channel. Slap a couple of bolts through the eyelets, cinch them down, and the front leaf spring is secured. Much of the Land Rover's frame design was the result of their initiative to simplify the production to effectively use limited materials after World War II. When moving on the rear suspension, I apply the same technique, working smarter, not harder.
Well, the suspension and the chassis now look great, and all the mechanical stuff is fit for purpose, which is fantastic. So our foundation has been restored, but clearly we've still got a lot of building work to do before we're ready to escape the apocalypse. Now time to think about all the equipment we might need for a bug-out vehicle. Now, traditionally, there's all kinds of things, from first aid kits, tools, solar arrays, winches, you name it, but the most important thing has got to be a reliable and plentiful water supply. Now, to that end, we're going to fit a pump which is going to drag the water from whatever water supply you manage to find. So whether it's a river, a lake, a pond, or maybe even a puddle, it's then going to push that water through a filtration system which is going to purify the water, and then it's going to be stored in a couple of tanks that will be on board on the vehicle ready for later on. All I have to do now is work out where and how it's all going to be attached to the car. I've chosen 2 9-gallon clear water tanks for water storage because they're robust and will protect our vital source of H2O. Right, so now we can try the other side. Just pop that in like so, and that is already looking pretty good. So a bit of plumbing, obviously, and it's quite lucky that it's actually sitting on the chassis mounts down the bottom there, because of course once these are actually full up, that's quite a lot of water, quite a lot of weight, and there's still plenty of room for our filters and some batteries. It's going well. Now, having sorted out exactly where I want to keep our water tanks, I've now protected them from the environment by boxing them in on both sides, which is great. Now, I've also bolted a water pump very securely to the chassis here. That's been nice and protected and out of the way. And the idea is, of course, that's going to push the water from the tanks all the way to the tap, which will be hidden in the cab. So we can pump dirty water in and clean water out. Now, from this side, you really can see that the inner wings are protecting the tanks from the outside world, which is great. They're now in position, and I've connected them up, and you can see I've used slightly bigger bore tubing. That gives us a bit more capacity, and of course it helps with the flow as you're trying to fill them up. Now, I've got some aluminium covers. Now, they're nice and thin. They're actually just going to cover up either of these holes so you can't see the tanks at all, and of course it gives me the option of putting the original seats back into that position. We don't really want people to know that we have all this clever water system on board, so I've made another cover. And once it's actually painted up, we'll hide our tubing nicely.
I'm using pop rivets rather than screws to secure the covers. This makes access a bit more troublesome, but it's well worth the added security.
Click here to subscribe.